Hello everyone, I hope you all are doing great. In today's tutorial, I'm gonna show you Heartbeat Sensor Library version 2 for Proteus. The link of this tutorial is given in the description of this YouTube video, and when you click on that link, you will come to this page which is on our blog, theengineeringprojects.com, and from this page you can easily download this second version of Heartbeat Sensor Library. I have already posted the first version of Heartbeat Sensor Library, and in that version I have used the test pin as digital. There was a fixed heartbeat sensor pattern installed in that sensor, in that first version of heartbeat sensor, and it doesn't perform any variable heartbeats. Like suppose if you are taking a walk, and then your heartbeat will be different, and if you are running, then your heartbeat will increase. So now, first of all, let me show you how to use this second version of heartbeat sensor in Proteus. So you can download the heartbeat sensor library by clicking this button, download library files, and the link of this post is given in the description of this YouTube video. So now I'm gonna download this library. I haven't purchased the license for WinRAR. Okay, now this is a Proteus simulation which I'm gonna show you later. First of all, I'm gonna place the library files in the library folder of Proteus software. So I'm gonna open this folder, and I'm gonna select all these four files, and I'm gonna extract them to library folder. And if you have seen, then we have two hex files in it. The first one is heartbeat sensor TEP.hex, and the second one is heartbeat sensor TEP2.hex. And this first file is for the first version of heartbeat sensor, while this second file is for second version of heartbeat sensor. If you have installed the previous version, then that's fine. These files will override them. So I'm gonna move to program files and then lab center, and I'm gonna select Proteus 7, and here I'm gonna select the library folder. I'm clicking OK. I'm gonna run this Proteus simulation. And now, as you can see, we have our heartbeat sensor. And now I'm gonna double click it to open its properties, and here I'm gonna select the heartbeat sensor TEP2, and I'm clicking OK. Now, as you can see, I have placed a variable resistor on its test pin, and I have provided ground to the ground pin plus 5 volt to VCC, and I have connected an oscilloscope at its out pin. So now we are gonna see how the heartbeat pattern will change when you will change the value of this variable resistance. So now I'm gonna run this Proteus simulation, and as you can see, we have this oscilloscope right in front of us, and now we have our heartbeat patterns. So now when it's 1, it means heart is beating, and when it's low, that means the pause between heart beatings. So now I'm gonna reduce my variable resistance, and soon you will see the heartbeat has increased, means now the heart is pumping fast. Now I'm gonna increase this variable resistance, and you will see we will have a great decline in heartbeat pattern. Now it's beating slowly. And if I increase it even more, then you will see our heart is getting more slow. So that's how now you can have any kind of heartbeat pattern in your. So now, if you are working on some project in which you need to set some checks on the heartbeat counting, then you can simply use this heartbeat sensor. Suppose I want to know if my patient's heartbeat value is increasing 100, then you can check by changing the value of this variable register. So when the heartbeat will exceed 100 value, then you can like turn on any buzzer or LED. So that's all about heartbeat sensor library version 2 in Proteus. And if you wanna use version 1, then you can also use that. And we have both of these versions, heartbeat sensor 1 and heartbeat sensor 2. So thanks for watching and subscribe to our YouTube channel to get these exciting tutorials right in your email. Take care. Bye-bye.